Hi, I'm Kate, and on this episode of Bite Size, we're exploring plants, specifically growing plants for food, like fruits and vegetables. Now, plants are essential for life on Earth. They provide us with oxygen that we breathe, and they provide not just us, but all organisms with food. But what do plants need in order to survive? Well, if you've ever grown plants before, two things might come to mind: sunlight and water. Now, there's a third thing that's equally important to plants. You probably used it, but may not have thought that closely about it. It's soil. But what is soil? Well, at a first glance, you might see rocks, silt, clay. It kind of just looks like dirt, but there's lots of living organisms inside the soil. It's an ecosystem full of living organisms and resources that work together. Some of those organisms we might be able to see, like earthworms, bugs, or roots of plants. Others we might need a microscope to see, like bacteria and fungi. These are called microorganisms because we need a microscope to see them. Additionally, there are nutrients in the soil. Now, you might have heard of the word nutrients before, but what exactly are nutrients? Well, in order to figure this out, we have to go to our periodic table of elements. Here, we can see that there are 17 elements that plants need. Some elements, like oxygen and hydrogen, plants can get from water or air. But for the majority of these elements, both ones that are needed in large amounts and in small amounts, plants get them from soil. Now, there's one element in particular we're going to focus on today, and it's one that both gardeners and farmers talk a lot about. It's nitrogen. Nitrogen is the building block of life, of cells. Plants need nitrogen in order to build cells. So this little leaf here is made of tons of cells, and all of those cells need nitrogen in order to exist. So nitrogen is really important. Now, every plant is a little bit different and is going to have different nutrient needs, but they all do need nitrogen to some extent. All right, so nitrogen is important, but where do we get it? Well, it's abundant. It's literally everywhere around us. It's in the air around us, it's in water, it's in these plants, it's even in us. Now, plants get nitrogen through soil, specifically through the roots in the soil. So to understand how this works in terms of gardening and farming, we have to think a little bit about how this actually works in nature. So plants are going to take in nitrogen through their roots, and as they continue to grow in the soil, they're essentially absorbing more and more nitrogen from the soil, so there's less and less nitrogen in the soil as the plant grows because it's going to the plant. Now, in nature, so like not in this garden, not in a farm, but like just in this backyard, that nitrogen will eventually go back into the soil through the nitrogen cycle. A couple different ways in which that might work is if the plant dies and decomposes, the nitrogen in that plant will eventually get back into the soil. Or maybe an animal eats that plant and then poops, and that poop actually contains nitrogen, as well as being kind of gross, but the nitrogen will actually eventually get back into the soil as well. But when we're farming or gardening, we're harvesting the crop, which means we're pulling the crop out of the soil and removing the nitrogen from the ecosystem because we're eating it. Additionally, nitrogen moves fairly easily. For example, let's take a big rainfall. That rain can actually cause the nitrogen to seep out of the soil and essentially drag it to other places. Not only is this not helpful for the plants because they're losing nitrogen from the soil, but it also has negative impacts on our environment, like local bodies of water. So when we're thinking about farms and gardening, and this on a larger scale, we have to think about how we're going to add nitrogen back into the soil because we've removed some of it. So because we're kind of interrupting that natural nitrogen cycle when we're harvesting plants, we have to think about how we can add nitrogen back into the soil and make sure that the soil is replenished and has enough nitrogen to support plant growth. There are a couple different ways in which we can do that.
The first option is fertilizer. Now, there are many different types of fertilizer. We could do a man-made one, like from a bag, or we could do natural sources of fertilizer, like manure or compost.
However, too much of either of those things, and that can have negative impacts for the environment. Luckily, there's a third option called crop rotation, which is essentially borrowing principles of nature. And this idea of biodiversity and having many different types of plants all planted in the same place. Crop rotation is essentially changing what type of crop is being planted in a specific area.
So for example, a farmer may plant corn one year, and then the following year they plant something else, like soybeans.
Now, can we just do any old plant? Well, I guess we could, and that might help us, but there are ways that we can be really strategic about which type of plants we use. Specifically, there's one type of plant called legume plants that are really helpful to nurturing our soil and replenishing it with nitrogen. So what's a legume? Well, here's a common example you might see at a school garden or a backyard garden, peas. Beans are another common example. These aren't as common on commercial farms. Instead, we'd probably see soybeans as well as alfalfa. Alfalfa might not sound that familiar, but it's the crop that we use to make hay for cows and other livestock. So it's a really important crop. Now, like we said before, legumes are special. We can rotate these crops in to help replenish the soil with nitrogen. But they don't do this alone. They have a small, but mighty teammate, bacteria. And no, not the bacteria that make you sick. In fact, actually, most species of bacteria on our planet are helpful and beneficial. Now, these bacteria in particular live on the roots of the legume plant. The legume plant has little growths from their roots called nodules. And these nodules are essentially homes for the bacteria to live in and to populate it. So essentially, what these bacteria do is make sure that the nitrogen is ready to use by the plant. The way in which they do that is actually pretty complex. It's called nitrogen fixation. We've linked more resources below if you're curious about it and want to learn the details.
When we harvest those legumes, the nitrogen that's been collecting in those nodules in the roots will stay in the soil and decompose and be available to other future plants that will be planted in that soil. So what can you do? Well, first, we should note that there's a pretty big difference between a large-scale commercial farm that's feeding thousands of people versus a home or school garden. But there are some common themes. First, soil is incredibly important to providing nourishing nutrients like nitrogen to our plants. And just like soil takes care of plants, we need to take care of our soil and nurture it as well. And one of the best ways we can do that is borrowing principles of nature and making sure there's a diverse array of vegetables and plants that we're growing from year to year.
We hope you learned something new on this episode of Bite Size. Be sure to like and subscribe for more videos.